Hey guys, Brewery602 Beer Reviews here, at Brewery602 on Instagram. My name is Marcus, and today I have a beer out of Wrenhouse Brewing Company located in Phoenix, Arizona, and they recently purchased a brewery out in Prescott, Arizona. This is Rebuild the Guild. It is a benefit beer to help benefit the Arizona Craft Brewers Guild. The Arizona Craft Brewers Guild is essentially a entity that will help all of the breweries in Arizona as far as, you know, informing them of the new laws coming out, you know, what they can and can't do as a brewery. They'll go to bat for them, you know, as far as like legislation is concerned. So it's kind of like that little, you know, the machine that helps run the craft brewery scene in Arizona. Very important, you know, company the Arizona Craft Brewers Guild is. And they also put on festivals. So like I've brewed at a couple of their festivals, like Strong Beer Festival. There was one at a baseball field called Salt River Fields here in Arizona where the Arizona Diamondbacks and Colorado Rockies play. Colorado Rockies play, easy for you to say. You know, there was a festival there that I was able to brew at as well. So it's you know, vitally important that the Craft Brewers Guild survive with no festivals going on because of the pandemic. A lot of money was lost. You know, those big money makers were gone. So these breweries that have been supported by the guild, you know, over all these years since the 90s, decided to do a benefit beer to help fund this guild because it is a, you know, not-for-profit kind of organization. And kind of fund the guild and get them the funds they need to put on these festivals and, you know, continue on and not go out of business. So this is a benefit beer. It's a hazy IPA coming in at 7.9% ABV, I believe. ABV wise, Wrenhouse does not put it on the can. That's one of the kind of strikes against their cans is they don't put ABV or like can on dates and stuff like that. So you kind of have to look it up. And I did look it up on Untappd, and I think it was 7.9 if I remember. Anyways, let's crack it open. A lot of the breweries did put out these beers, like I said. I have tried pretty much all of them that have come out so far, except for the ones in Tucson that haven't distributed, you know, to Phoenix yet. So if it's local, I know the Beer Research Institute did one. I went out and got that at Beer Research Institute. We call it BRI here. Huss Brewing did it. I went and grabbed a four pack from Huss. Fate Brewing did it. So I went out and grabbed a four pack from Fate. So, Pedal House did it, but they did not distribute it. They just did it in-house. So went in-house to go try it. Just trying, you know, to do my part as far as helping out the Craft Brewers Guild, because again, you know, I've been able to do brew outs at those festivals and meet a lot of people. And so, you know, I got to try to support as much as I can. The beer here comes in a hazy yellow color, really nice light color, light hay-like color with a tight, compact head on that. Didn't pour very much head. I didn't pour it very hard either. But anyways, let's get a drive-by aroma. There's a lot of grapefruit. Like a big spritz of grapefruit. Definitely has that sharp mango pineapple character in there as well. The aroma is Wrenhouse. I guess that's the easiest way for me to say it. And if you haven't had a Wrenhouse beer, I'm sorry, but they do use their house yeast, and that's the aroma. It has a really nice, like, flaked oat or like an oat-like character. But that grapefruit, like it's a grapefruit, like spritzer kind of thing, like ruby red grapefruit, and the that pineapple mango thing are just really, really nice. And even there's a slight hit of dankness in the background too, so that's really nice. Let me get a deeper aroma. Yeah, on the deeper aroma, the dankness definitely comes out a lot more. So it has a nice fruity dankness to it, like a little overripe peach also kind of hidden in there as well. Need the haste on it. Cheers. I mean, what can you say? It's a Wrenhouse beer. So, you know, mouthfeel is really nice, medium mouthfeel, nice and fluffy. That like ruby red grapefruit is really pronounced in this. So they probably use a lot of like Simcoe puts off kind of like that ruby red. But it also has like a little bit of a lemon zest character as well. So it's like, it's almost, there's no bitterness, by the way, like not a shot of bitterness at all. So it's almost like West Coast without the bitterness. I don't know if that's a thing. Yeah, probably not. It's still New England style if there's no bitterness to it. But definitely has that ruby red thing. Definitely has like a lemon zest kind of thing going on with it. And it's really well balanced with like these oat kind of character as well. Yeah, that little like lemon zest kind of thing really helps out, you know, push the that oat or wheat character out quite a bit. Really plays really well. It's extremely easy drinking. It's basically a double IPA, but extremely easy. It's clean. It's smooth. Great summer beer. In Arizona, we're going to be hitting the 90s already, believe it or not, and we're still barely touched spring, so it's going to be a probably be a rough summer. Fantastic beer. Wrenhouse, I mean, what can you say? It's a great brewery. Score-wise, I'd go 95 on it. It's definitely a great beer, so I'd go 95. Again, this is Wrenhouse Brewing Company, located in Phoenix, Arizona. Rebuild the Guild, and if you do happen to live in Arizona and you're watching this, go try to get as many of these Guild beers that you can, because it is vitally important that we do support the Arizona Craft Brewers Guild. Anyway, my name is Marcus. It's Brewery 602 Beer Reviews, at Brewery 602 on Instagram. Please follow, like, and subscribe. Cheers.